I've just celebrated my second lockdown birthday. I managed to sneak another one in before things start to open up a bit more next week. And I've been thinking about celebrations and also the anticipation that comes beforehand. You know, sometimes the build-up towards an event is almost as exciting as the event itself, the looking forward, the expecting, the anticipating. And that led me to think about our Easter week journey. Because sometimes I think we can get to Easter Sunday and have Easter eggs and hot cross buns and roast lamb for lunch and hopefully get together with some friends or family. And that's great. But we've missed some of the story that comes before and the anticipation and the build-up that can help us really experience that celebration more fully. So that's what this Easter week journey is about. It's about taking some time each day this week to think about the events in the build-up to Easter so that we can celebrate together next Sunday. And whether this story is one that's really familiar to you, or perhaps it's one you're looking at afresh, or maybe for the very first time, we're so glad that you've joined us. So today in the Christian calendar is called Palm Sunday. And it describes a time when Jesus was coming to Jerusalem. In fact, he was coming for a party. He was coming with his friends. And every year, as many Jews as were able to would go to Jerusalem at this time of year to celebrate a feast, a festival called the Passover. It was a really special occasion. It was a time when the Jewish people remembered how God had rescued them from slavery in Egypt thousands of years before. So it was a time of celebration, of family, of community. And it was also a time of looking forward with expectation because God had promised that he would send somebody to rescue them again. And at this time, about 2,000 years ago, the Jews were under Roman oppression. They were really feeling the pinch. Life was hard and it wasn't anything like the good future that they had hoped for. And so they were longing that God would keep his promise and would send somebody to rescue them. So on this occasion, Jesus came into Jerusalem. In fact, as he came close to the city, he sent some of his friends ahead of him and said, I want you to go to that village and outside a house, you're going to see a donkey and a colt, a young donkey tied up. Untie them and bring them to me. And if anybody challenges you, just say the master needs them. So two of his friends went along, they found the donkey, they untied it. And as Jesus had expected, somebody challenged them. But they were allowed to take the donkey with them when they said the master needs it. They brought the donkey to Jesus. He sat on it and he rode into Jerusalem. Now Jesus had been living and working over the past 3 years doing amazing things. The Bible tells us that he was a great teacher. He explained the things of God in a way that people were amazed and delighted by. But not only was he a talker, he was a doer. And he brought change to people's lives. They saw him as he healed sick bodies, as he freed people from years of pain and oppression, as he spoke life and truth and forgiveness to those who were caught up and bound up in guilt and in the pain of the past. So he said amazing things and he did amazing things. And coming into Jerusalem on this day, on this donkey, was a fulfillment of what had already been started, because this was his way of saying, here I am. I'm the king that God's promised. Now you might think, how does riding on a donkey show you that? Well, there had been ancient promises written in the Jewish scriptures hundreds of years before. A number of different ones, and one of them particularly was that the king would come riding on a donkey. Because in those days, like now, you'd expect a king to come with loads of pomp and circumstance and ceremony. And instead, Jesus came showing that he was coming in peace and coming to fulfill this promise. Well, the people realized what was going on and recognized it. They celebrated, they shouted, Hosanna, blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. And really, that kind of could be translated now to say, hooray, the King's coming, the rescuer's coming. And they cut down palm branches from the trees and put them in front of him. That's why we call this Palm Sunday. And they took off their coats and they laid them out as a way of demonstrating they wanted the King to kind of come and be welcomed. But there were also people who criticized and who just said, you are not this king. You can't do this. Who do you think you are? And so as we start our Easter week journey this week, that could be a good question for us. Are we going to be like the masses of people who welcomed Jesus, who celebrated his arrival? Or are we those people who go, you're not this person, and who criticise and decide not to open their hearts? It's a choice that we can make. And perhaps as you think about it today, you might just like to pray with me. Lord Jesus, I ask that this week you would show me who you are, that you'd become more real to me than ever before. I'm really open to hearing what it is that you've got to say. Amen. Look forward to seeing you tomorrow.